Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce you to the companion deck to Dear Human Child, a book of received transmissions, and how to use this deck for a three-card spread. Understanding that the cards are taken from segments of all the transmissions in the book. So together, they become a visceral tool by which you can use these activating transmissions for your own support, guidance, and care. This deck is a full 108 cards, similar to Tarot in that both shadow and light are addressed, and similar to divination cards in the pure angelic love found within every word. And what we're going to do today is to take this prototype deck and ask a universal question of the guides. Please tell us how each one of us can process the degree of ongoing violence and division that is taking place on the planet today in a three-card spread. Now, the only way I can shuffle this sample deck, because the cards are so large, is to stack them. But, of course, the professionally produced ones you receive will be poker size, light and malleable, so you can shuffle the entire 108 card deck in your hands easily. So now, please tell us, how can we manage these really challenging personal and planetary energies, and in a three-card spread, which means we have one which shows us where we're coming from, and then a center card which tells us more about where we are in the moment, and a third card which shows us movement and development, that toward which we are moving, and how to assist the unfolding of the journey. Okay, so I'm going to cut the deck. Card number one. And then I'm going to reshuffle, and I'm going to say card number two, please, for this question. There we go, card number two. And now, with intention, card number three, please, for this three-card spread, which will reveal an entire story when we line these cards up together. All right, now, card number one. The greatest beasts of our nightmares may be purified by our choice to deny them the food of our fear. Cast blind faith of love upon them instead, and they will melt before our eyes. And this is from a transmission called The Light That Is. So that's where we're coming from, where we're being asked to understand and work deeply with our personal fear. Card number two. Remembering the center card gives us the central principle and reminds us of where we are right now. There is no life without breath, as there is no breath without expansion and retreat. The universe breathes. It has always breathed and always will, in one form of inhalation or exhalation at all times. And in this we find the presence of polarity, and therefore the gift of opposition and flow. Oh my goodness. So this is from Cycles of Breath, and what a powerful card. This is asking us, even in these very difficult times, to have an understanding of the purpose and nature of duality, and therefore discover the meaning within our suffering and the suffering of others, even when we feel far from the light and the peace we desire. So we'll come back to this important principle, but let's have a look at the third card. How do I live beyond fear, you ask? You look it in the eye. Stand quaking in the God love of your own heart and dare anything else to deny you this, for it cannot. The light that is. Isn't it interesting how this card almost speaks our question? How do I live beyond fear? And also interesting that we have cards on both ends from the transmission, the light that is. So I'm hoping this spread can give you an idea of how there's movement when you use more than one card from the deck together, so that these excerpts can tell us a story. So we begin with a reminder that our decision to have choice around the fear that we experience can conquer even the greatest shadows, the greatest beasts of our nightmares. And the central principle is the invitation to understand that light and dark have always been at play, that in fact, just as we have inhalation and exhalation, just as we have life and death, we have light and we have shadow. And where there is great light, there will be great shadow. It's how it works. And in this polarity, we are then ready to understand the gift of opposition and flow, and how it is within this understanding that we will find the very meaning within our suffering, the initiation of our transformation. Within what this card states, we find the core principle of why we suffer and how we can transform that suffering. And then, of course, we ask, but how do I live beyond my fear? Well, you look it in the eye. You stand quaking in the God love of your own heart and dare anything else to deny you this, for it cannot. We must not turn away. We must acknowledge. We must bear witness to all that is before us. And even as we feel fear, we turn to the God love within our own heart and we say, nothing. Nothing can deny this. Nothing can deny this spirit. And I will stay rooted in this. I will stay centered and grounded in this aspect of my being. And as I do this, I make the choice. I make the choice not to feed my fear, but rather to surrender to a higher knowing and trust, and thus play my part to raise the frequency of myself, my own being, and therefore the collective and the all. So if these three cards can address such a challenging question, imagine how they can support you with the more personal questions that you have. If this guidance can help you come to terms with the level of suffering we are seeing on a global scale, imagine if you had these cards to work with every day, whenever something arises and you feel confused or you are seeking understanding. This is my mission and my purpose in offering this collection of transmissions and the companion card deck. This is not just a book and it's not just a deck, it is a tool. When you work with your deck and the book, read these words aloud and notice how you feel. Where do these words take you? And in your awareness, recognize your consciousness, and in your consciousness, let your frequency bring you home. Please support this project to make these tools of comfort, knowledge, and transformation available to all who will benefit in these times. Learn all about it and the campaign at dearhumanchild.com.